Let's go ahead and move on to Troll. Remember, thanks so much again, those of you at home, for tuning in and watching along with us live here on YouTube, Facebook, Twitch, and Twitter. Don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe and follow and hit that notification bell if you haven't already. And remember, if you have any trailers, weird news headlines, or dad jokes to suggest, use the contact form on our Linktree page, which is scrolling at the bottom of the screen. Please, no religious or political content. Keep the suggestions recent and the trailers under 5 minutes long. And as always, if you're with us live, please keep dropping those comments. I almost said lines. Dropping those lines. Dropping those sick rap bars and beats. Yo, I don't know. Never mind. Sorry, I'll stop. Keep commenting in the live chat, and we just might read it off on the air. Last one we have is another thing from Netflix called Troll, and John Clem 310, you're up next. Say again?
Yeah, John Clem 310. Let's see it. Troll.
All right, here we go. Here's Troll, followed by our special guest, John Clem 310's reaction on the flip. Let's take a look.
Det utrolige ikke umulig.
Jeg fortalte dere at for 1000 år siden vandret troll omkring.
We are on the ground here in Norway.
People running for their lives.
Imagine the consequences.
Hva det der?
Jeg ikke kvalifisert til å svare på hva dette jeg.
Men vi trenger noe som det.
Hvor Gidman?
Statsministeren har gitt deg status som vitenskapelig rådgiver.
Dere vet at jeg graver opp fossiler.
Det noe som kom ut av fjellet I dag.
King Kong? Kanskje?
Wrong franchise.
Start opp.
Du vet det at det snev av sannhet I alle eventyr.
Herregud.
La oss utrydde den før den utrydder oss.
Dette eventyr har så vidt begynt.
Mye militær erfaring, eller?
En del.
Ja.
Call of Duty.
Womp womp.
Naturen kommer til å slå tilbake.
Hey ho.
Let's go.
Huh. Okay, so that was Troll, which is coming to Netflix on December 1st. So, whoops, hang on, sorry, I hit the wrong thing. Ah, there we are. Okay, so yeah, Troll, Netflix, December 1st.
Type of monster movie made in a Scandinavian way. I mean, I like watching Netflix Scandinavian content. It's usually good.
You sound a little bit muffled. It sounds like you said this is going to be good.
Yeah, I like it. Yeah, I like the trailer. Thumbs up.
Okay.
I like the humor throughout the trailer. Like the slight, like, Scandinavian humor to it, you know what I'm saying? And more, you know what I'm saying? More subtle about it, you know what I'm saying? More downbeat, you know what I'm saying? Not as obvious as America's. I can feel that in the trailer.
You know, honestly, this reminds me a lot of the Roland Emmerich Godzilla movie from 1998. This footage right here, this scene right here, like passing underneath the foot, that really reminds me of that movie. In fact, I bet if this movie had been made 20 years ago, there would have been a Saturday morning cartoon based off of this. And I know this because it was a Saturday morning cartoon based off of Roland Emmerich's Godzilla movie from 1998. It only lasted like one or two seasons, but like we've seen this sort of work in that context. pretty decently for the time. It was really brief, but it worked out at least enough to spawn the cartoon, like I was saying. So I don't know what else really to sort of take away from this. But John, it sounds like you were giving this a thumbs up. John, say that again.
Yeah, sorry, I'm getting interrupted by my mom. Yeah, yeah, no. Yeah, yeah, I was being distracted by my mom, but otherwise, yeah, I like the trailer.
Okay, so so thumbs up or thumbs down?
Yeah, thumbs up, thumbs up, thumbs up. Okay. I mean, who else decided for a troll? Okay. No, no, Don, I just got to make another point. Have you guys seen Troll 2?
Have not.
I recommend seeing it. It's one of those films so bad that...
Troll 2? Do you mean that you're saying there's a second one of these already?
No. It's like an 80s B-movie. It's an 80s B-horror movie, yeah. It's like, it's very poorly made, but it's entertaining.
And what's it called? Troll 2? The number 2?
Yeah. Troll 2, yeah. Look it up on YouTube.
I've never heard of it. It's on YouTube. Okay.
Look it up.
Well, after we wrap, let's go ahead and maybe this is something to look into because, like, we're trying to finish this show here. but okay, cool. So that's a thumbs up from Troll, on Troll, excuse me, from our special guest John Clem 310, and Troll once again is hitting Netflix on December 1st. So now that the playlist is done, we're at the top of the hour here. So now we have to go through our favorite trailers of the week, and then we have to go ahead and do dad joke of the day. So first, I guess, special guest, you want to go first? What was your favorite trailer of the week?
My favorite trailer? Go with Spirited.
Okay. Why?
Why? Because Ryan Reynolds is in it and basically plays Deadpool bouncing off of Will Ferrell. And it's just like in this holiday season coming up. So, yeah, it was my favorite trailer.
Okay. Okay. Cool. Kaiko, you're most senior person on staff. What's your next favorite?
So go out. Let me see. So I think I'm the most excited about Avatar coming out. But right. I don't know if that was my favorite trailer. Let's see. Yeah, it was. It was. I give it to Avatar because that it, you know.
It's like I'm not even here. It's like everything I said, explaining the litany of reasons why it was a bad idea to make this movie. And here comes Kaiko at the end of the show.
Well, listen. Listen, that's why I say, because I didn't say, I'm saying it wasn't the best trailer, but I think I'm the most excited to see this movie because I'm just glad they brought it back. So I think it hit me the most that in that way. But no, it wasn't the best trailer. I know what you're saying. All right. So out of all of them, the best trailer that they did go down. So then that's just Troll. I think that Troll was the best trailer then.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, Lloyd. What about you?
Was that Enchanted?
Yeah, Disenchanted.
Oh, the Disenchanted. Man, that was pretty cool.
The thing that caused problems for our YouTube stream in the middle of it.
Right.
Enchanted it. But yeah, I would give it to that. I mean, it has all the elements when you're looking for a, what do you call this? When you're looking for a movie trailer. Though A Christmas Story has another concept of voiceover, which I'm really a fan of. I was like, oh, man, look at that. But I'm gonna give it to the Disenchanted.
Okay. And Lloyd, I agree with you that it was a good trailer. I still feel like that movie's gonna be kind of cheesy. Mm-hmm. Disney's just getting cheesier. That's all I can say. So maybe it's not the trailer, it's just Disney. That's throwing its taste in my mouth, I guess is what I'm saying.
Maybe just outside the target audience.
Right. So yeah. I don't know. But I feel, it was a good trailer. I could have gave it to that one, too.
Okay, cool. I'm going to go ahead and plus one John's stance and give favorite trailer of the week to Spirited, because there is no way I'm giving it to Avatar. I'm not giving favorite trailer of the week to Avatar. I'm swiping left on that thing. But Spirited, it's the casting is on point. It's the holiday time is coming up, and you know, it's kind of going back to the well to make yet another Christmas Carol. But like, as long as if you're going to remake something, as long as you can do it in a way that feels more genuinely fresh on the surface than it really is, it can sort of get away with not being as fresh as it should be. Especially if you're talking about something that's going to theaters where I have to put down ticket money. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Yeah. The 2020 is up there in Christmas Carol. No.
Say again, John. I'm sorry.
The 2020 update of a Christmas Carol, and it feels fresh.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Right. I agree. Yeah, it's almost like a modern, like 30 years later version of that Bill Murray movie from 1988. I want to say that was Scrooged, which is the closest thing that to compare it to. I think I made that comparison the last footage of this movie that we had on this show reacting to that show. But anyway.